Here in this video, we will show you how to migrate my website step by step from localhost XAMPP server to real live cPanel server. You might have purchased a new cPanel hosting and now you don't know how to upload your localhost website from localhost XAMPP server to real working live server. So, first of all, go to localhost/phpMyAdmin. This will reach you towards MySQL databases. Now, you need to select the database which you would like to export. So, if WordPress is your database, simply click over WordPress and then click over Export. Now from here, you simply need to click over Go. This will help you to download WordPress.sql file. Here, our database name was WordPress. In your case, it may be something else. So, file name might vary. Now open this file via Notepad++. If you don't have Notepad++, you can also open this file via Notepad. Now find and replace localhost with your real working domain name. This is the domain name that you have bought. Now replace all occurrences. If you click over replace all, then it will replace all occurrences, as here it has replaced 10 occurrences. In your case, it might be something more or less. Now, save this file as it is with the same name and then again go to your cPanel account and then click over MySQL database. Now from here, we need to create a new database first. Enter any name over here and then click over create database. Yes, you can enter any name. Name doesn't matter. Make sure the overall database name is not more than 16 characters, as it does not support old database structures. Now once you have created a MySQL database name, now the turn has come to create MySQL users. Create a new user by entering the suffix and then enter the password, repeat your password and then click over create user. Make sure you are remembering all these things or noting it down somewhere, because you will be required MySQL username, MySQL database name as well as MySQL username's password in future. Once you have created MySQL username and its password, now the turn has come to add that user into the database. So let us select the user that we have created from here. In our case, there are several users, but don't worry, since you are a beginner, you might have only one user. Click over Add. Now assign all privileges and then finally click over Save. After clicking over Make Changes, your permissions will be saved successfully. Now again click over this square box to reach your cPanel homepage. Now you need to go to newly created database in MySQL, that is phpMyAdmin section, and then import the database. So go to phpMyAdmin and then click over that database which you created recently. Now from here click over import. Now from here click over browse and then upload the same file that you downloaded from localhost. Now after uploading this same file, click over go. In this way, you will be able to import the same file which you exported from localhost. The only difference is that we have replaced localhost with the real domain name. Now again go to your C drive and then go to XAMPP folder and then go to HT docs. Now from here, you will find your website data. This is what you have developed. So simply go inside that specific folder from here and then make it as a compressed zip file. You can also make 7jet or RAR. The main motive is to simply zip or simply create an archive. Now this zip file is created successfully. We will upload it directly inside cPanel by going inside File Manager and then go to public_html. Now inside public_html, you can create a new folder if you want to host your website inside a directory. If you directly want to host your website, no need to create this folder, simply upload the files over here. Whatever files you upload inside public_html is directly visible in your domain name. So finally, click over upload and then select the file and upload it. This will take some time and your compressed file will be uploaded successfully. Now extract this file so that we can unzip its contents. Now these contents are present similarly, just like it was present inside htdocs. Now from here, you need to select all the files which you have extracted and move it to the relevant location. If you want to locate it to the main website, obviously again, you can simply move them inside public_html. Now, once all the files are present in your live server perfectly, the time has come to edit your database detail from wp-config.php. In your case, if you have developed this site manually, then you need to find your own database config file. Now from here, you need to provide your database credential. So the time has come that you need to paste all your data that you created earlier. You created database name. Alright, simply go to DB name and then paste it over there. You also created a database user. Simply paste it instead of root. These are the details which you created in your cPanel account inside MySQL database section. You need to note down these details while you were creating, otherwise you may forget them. Now click over save changes. In this way, your wp-config.php file is now correctly connected with your database which is hosted in your cPanel. Now if you will open your website with exact URL, since we have uploaded our website inside WordPress folder, we will be able to check our website successfully inside the WordPress folder. In your case, if you have uploaded directly inside public_html, then this will be displayed as a home page. Now you can see that your real live website is completely running flawlessly in your domain name. Please subscribe to our channel if you have still not subscribed. If you want to buy best Linux web hosting services with 100% uptime, then RedServerHost.com is the best option for you. Grab now.